Hello and welcome back again to MBAbullshitDotCom. So the topic for this video is decision tree analysis, and this is the basic video on this topic. Alright, so remember, you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com. So this video completely explains the very basic decision tree concept. After this, you'll be ready for my next video on decision tree exam training to help you pass or get high grades. Alright, so let's start with a story. Let's say you can choose between two business projects, either a candy shop or a lemonade stand. Right? And let's say that the candy shop can earn up to $100 and the lemonade stand can earn up to $90. Which one should you do? Of course, the answer is quite easy and obvious. You should choose the candy shop in this simple situation. The what if? Okay, but what if? Let's make the story take the story a step further. What if the candy shop had a 50% chance of success and also had a 50% chance of failure? And if your candy shop is a success, you would earn $100. If it was a failure, you would lose $30. See, that's a negative sign there, a negative 30. On the other hand, if you have a lemonade stand, you also have a 50% chance of success and a 50% chance of failure. If it's a success, you would probably earn $90. If it's a failure, you would probably lose $10. Which one do you choose now? Okay, so now it's not so simple. Actually, it is very simple. You would use a simple formula like this. Okay? And it would look like this. -50% × $100 + 50% × -30, and we would get a figure here which we call an expected value. Now I'm going to explain that a little bit more in a while, so just be patient. Where did we get this 50% over here? It's the same as the 50% over here. Where did we get the $100 over here? It's the same as the $100 over here. Plus 50% over here corresponds to the 50% over here, chance of failure. Multiplied by negative 30, or loss of 30, where did we get that? It corresponds to the negative $30 over here. And now we come up with this $35. And then we do the same thing for the lemonade stand. 50%. Okay, 50% chance of success, $90 that you would earn if it's a success, plus 50% chance of failure, multiplied by the loss of $10, which you would get if, or which you would have if your lemonade stand becomes a failure. Okay, and we end up with this formula over here and this figure over here. 50% times 90 plus 50% multiplied by negative 10 equals $40. So now, which one would you choose? Obviously, would you choose the $35 or would you choose the $40? Obviously, you would choose the $40. And this $40 is what we call the expected value of the lemonade project. And the expected value of the candy project is $35. And since we're choosing a business, we choose the bigger one, the one with a bigger expected value. Now, I promised you I'd speak more on expected value. What do we mean by this? All right? Well, does this mean that if you do the lemonade project, you will earn $40? See? $40 over here. Does this mean you will earn $40? No. Okay? It means that if you did identical lemonade projects very many times in exactly the same situation as you have here, okay, if you did it very many times in exactly the same situation, then your average earnings will probably be $40 per time on the average. On the average. So it does not mean you'll earn $40 each time, and it certainly does not mean you will earn $40 this time. It just means your average earnings would be $40 if, in some strange world, you had the chance to replicate or duplicate exactly the same situation many, many times. Okay? So make sure that that's what you mean by you understand that that's what we mean by expected value. It is different from everyday street language. If we say, oh, I expect my friend to give me $5 today, that means he probably will give you exactly $5. But in MBA bullshit language, when we say expected value, it means what I just explained right now. Your average earnings in a certain situation, if you could replicate that same situation very many times. All right, so that's how simple it is. Okay, now you're ready for my next video. So this video we watched right now was just a very simple example, not enough to pass an exam or to get high marks or high grades. But still, you should have completely understood the concept, at least the concept in this video. So remember to share it if you like it. On Twitter, we're at simply MBA Bullshit. Facebook.com/MBAbullshit is the place to go to find out the latest updates from me and my latest videos. And please do forward our YouTube links on your email. So have a great day and goodbye.